with the crow, I tried to make them expressive like humans, still in that figurative mode, but more in an animal, a bird that I admire. And I also saw the show called A Murder of Crows about a year ago, and it inspired me because they're so intelligent. I didn't realize how intelligent they are and how much they are like us. They interact with us, they watch us, they're the tricksters and the wise guys in the bird world, and they are the smartest bird on the planet. And they're tool makers, problem solvers. So I just became fascinated with the crow. And then I had a crow encounter several times on a walk. And so there was these messages I was getting, omen for change. So I did it. So I decided to do my whole body of work for this particular show about crows. And me. It really, it was my personal journey with this birds, with the crows.
All of my work contains both the image of the person and then a message behind it that communicates some kind of feeling, connection, idea, or something that's interrelated with that person. But it kind of takes a step further because it's my writing, and also I'm physically writing into it. So with this idea of immortality and preservation with graphology, which is handwriting analysis, that's the idea of being able to identify someone based upon their handwriting. So even though I could be depicting somebody else other than myself, initially not only is it still a self-portrait because it's my interpretation of that individual, but also the act of me writing into the painting is preserving myself along with it. So it becomes a hybrid of preserving their identity and my own.